going to help us get amplification of genes. Why is such a necessity of amplification of gene has come? Look here, there are samples of DNA where we get a small amount of DNA and we cannot go through the entire process of other factors that we need to know from this DNA sample without going through the process of amplification. Amplification will help us to get multiple copies of that DNA. So this is a very big requirement. Before we go for any processing of PCR like polymerase chain reaction, which I have discussed in my video, the whole of the mechanism with denaturation, then annealing when the primers are added for denaturation, a temperature around 94 degrees centigrade is maintained, and time can be, you can say the time limit is 1 minute over there. And as far as primers, when annealing process takes place, these primers are short nucleotide sequences to oligonucleotide sequences which add up in two directions, either a forward or a reverse direction, and these are adding the short nucleotide sequences which are complementary to that DNA. That means first the melting and then the single stranded DNA will be having a complementary short nucleotide sequence which will be annealing. So that will be the second step, when the temperature is brought down to 45 to 55 range, you can say degrees centigrade, and the time can be 45 seconds. Then comes the last step, that is extension. After the primers anneal, it is the role of the TAC DNA or the Thermus aquaticus bacterium, where from we get the isolated TAC DNA polymerase. This is going to help adding one by one all the dNTPs, dATP, dGTP, dCTP, dTTP. So all of them are going to add one by one, and thus we are going to have a long strand. So this is a quick revision that I have given of the PCR mechanism. Next comes the PCR machine. Now see, as I have mentioned that amplification of gene is very important. Look, I have got a gene which is a very small, I'm not drawing it in the helical structure, I'm drawing it in this way. So this is a very small fragment. If I do not make multiple copies of this gene, I will not be able to study it for my purpose. That's why this amplification process is going to take place, where I will be getting multiple copies of this gene, and it cannot take place in the first step only so many copies. In the first step, it will be two, you can say, and from there again one of the strand will be acting as a template, and then again further copies can be made. It's like Xerox machine. So this machine, the thermocycler, is a machine where you will find I'm drawing a rough structure over here. So it can be, it has got some wells over here. These wells are actually having all of this material, like it's a PCR tube which has got a lid like structure. All of the material in the thermocycler, where there is a reaction mixture, you can see this reaction mixture is actually having the target DNA which is going to be amplified. The target DNA sequence must be known sequence. Without this, we will not be able to carry out PCR. So sequence should be known, a very important criteria in PCR. So these wells are going to load, whole of this material goes into these wells. This will have the target DNA. It will have other factors also, like besides having the target DNA, it will have the primers, which are short nucleotide sequences to oligonucleotide sequences that will be used, one in the reverse direction. It always goes on like this. Is if it is 5 prime 3 prime, it will free the hydroxyl end. So it will be adding over here. Let me use another color so that you can distinguish properly. These are short nucleotide sequences which are absolutely matching with these sequences over here. And this will be added in the 3 prime end, as it is going to free the 3 prime hydroxyl end. And then comes like primers, then the dNTPs, which is DNA segment or fragment. This is the 5 prime end, this is the 3 prime end. Now primers are short oligonucleotide sequences which are going to anneal in the 3 prime hydroxyl end. First of all, why primers are added in the 3 prime? Why we do not keep it in this end? This is one segment, this is another segment. Okay, so that means here the couplet, we have a two separate strand now, and these are pure strand, these are not hybrid ones. Now the question is that this is the 3 prime hydroxyl end. Now the question is that why we prefer to add the primers in the 3 prime hydroxyl ends? The reason is that primers are carrying short nucleotide sequences which should be complementary to this main strand, template strand. Okay. Now if these primers have such sequences, very important line, if the primers which are short nucleotide sequences, if these primers are having such sequences which are matching with themselves, means 4-5 matching sequences are there, then what will happen? They will bind with their own selves. That means a primer will become a dimer. A primer binds with another primer and becomes a dimer, and it forms like a hairpin like loop. So this is a very important factor, so we prefer this. Another point is that between G and C there are 3 hydrogen bonds. More of GC means more of stability is there in the strand. That means to break the stability we need a temperature also higher. So GC content is going to determine our temperature, that what temperature will be the melting temperature of the DNA. Already we know the melting temperature is 94 degrees centigrade, and the primer's annealing temperature is 45 to 55 degrees centigrade range. Now if these two temperatures, 94 degrees centigrade and 45 degrees centigrade, see there is a big difference between these two temperatures. If melting temperature, DNA melting temperature, very important sentence, should not be such that it is matching with the primer annealing. So this is one factor, known sequence is one factor, temperature should be kept in mind, GC content should be kept in mind. Primers, when they anneal, the complementary steel, that means they must not have 4-5 matching sequences so that they do not form hairpin like loop. A primer will become a dimer. And one more point I need to mention over here, just I'm going to point it to carry the complementary base pairs, short nucleotide sequences. Now this point is also to be kept in mind when the temperature range is going to be maintained, that is for melting it is 94, for annealing it is 45, and then the role of tag DNA polymerase. Now look, after one cycle what is happening? The strands separate, and this is the tag DNA which is going to play the role. Tag DNA polymerase is going to extend this strand. This is the tag DNA polymerase which is extending the strand. Extension process takes place. See, this is in forward direction, this is in reverse direction. So primers, here also one factor is there, that primers which are short nucleotide sequences are going to be added, one in forward direction, one in reverse direction. And we prefer to add the primers in the 3 prime hydroxyl end, keeping in mind that there is not too many matching sequences. Also the target DNA should be known to us. These are, I mean, some of the points that I'm summarizing. Still now there are many points to be discussed. And next factor that has to be kept in mind, after 2 cycles you can take, what is happening? This is the pure strand. This strand that I have got over here is a pure one. So this is a pure strand, this is also a pure strand, but this is a hybrid strand and this is also a hybrid strand. Now what is happening after 2 cycles? What the point is, the primers start being added after the main DNA. That means this, if this is the main target DNA, look here, I'm going to rub this part and then I'm going to draw. This is a very important factor that has to be understood, that this is the target DNA. After that comes the primers which are getting annealed. Now what is happening? This is overhanging, this is the primer region, this is the target DNA, and again primers start adding. So after multiple cycles, very important, after multiple cycles, what really happens is the target DNA comes in the middle part, and adjoining region to at the two sides comes the primers. So we have to carry on the PCR machine multiple number of times so that we get finally a pure strand. This is a pure strand. This is also a pure strand, but this is a hybrid strand. Look, it has, this is only about one cycle. After many cycles, the situation arises that it becomes over here, it comes over here, the prime, the target DNA comes here and the primers are coming after it. This is one point that has to be kept in mind. Next is tagged DNA polymerase. Now, advantages, I will come to it little later. Tagged DNA polymerase properties. Is it that we do not have any other choice? Of course we have. There are other DNA polymerase also which can be used. For example, now I am going to just remove, I am erasing this part, I have covered this part. So there are lots of information more, but at this moment I will just focus on this. So what really happens is in tagged DNA polymerase, the benefit is there on orthotermos aquaticus. Now tagged DNA is a very common name DNA polymerase that is used. This, it is from extracted from the bacterium Thermus aquaticus present in hot springs. Now tagged DNA polymerase, what is the role? See here, though it is preferred to be used, but there is a choice of using another also, PFU DNA polymerase, which is yet giving us a better result. Look, I'll tell you why. What is happening? This is from the Pyrococcus furiosus. This is the isolation is from the Pyrococcus furiosus. This is hyperthermophilic, you can say, and it has got a benefit of having the exonuclease activity. What we know about tagged DNA polymerase that it is, that its fidelity rate is very less. What is meant by this fidelity rate? That in the 3' hydroxylant, the exonuclease activity lacks. Now what is this exonuclease activity? Let's discuss the exonuclease activity. Exonuclease activity. Exo means exterior or outside. When the primers are getting added, then the DNTPs are being added by the tagged DNA. This is the tagged DNA extending the strand. How? By adding one by one all the DNTPs. What is happening? The mismatch, wherever we find the errors are there, tagged DNA is unable to remove those mismatch sequences, which PFU DNA polymerase is able to remove. So exonuclease activity is lacking over here. It lacks. But here exonuclease activity is there. So this is a very big benefit is present, where proofreading can be done. Proofreading means your errors while the primers and the DNTPs, let me talk about the DNTPs. The DNTPs are added one by one. The mismatched pairs should be removed immediately before the extension of the strand. That means much earlier than this extension, where the strand is getting extended, before that, whatever the mismatch sequences are present in the strand, it is the activity of this PFU DNA polymerase which is high, having this exonuclease activity, and proofreading is done. That means it is a spell check, you can say. In your computer, in our computers, we have the spell check facility where checking is done. So checking is done by PFU Pyrococcus furiosus. This DNA polymerase is having a benefit of having this proofreading activity, where it removes the nucleotides which are having some mismatch sequences one by one. Immediately it removes. As soon as it finds error, it removes, which is not there in tagged DNA polymerase. Proofreading, certain disadvantage that it is not having the facility of proofreading. That means it is more prone to make errors. the error rate could be 2 into 10 to the power of minus 4 errors per basis. These are number of errors per base, you can say. Why such thing is happening? Because it is not able to remove the mismatched sequences that are happening. Like in the 3 prime end, whatever the complementary base pairs are found, this thermocycler is that you cannot check your work in between. Once you load everything, you have to run the process in between. There is no such checking. So there is a big problem you have to keep in mind. Other than that, there are some other factors. Means after running the entire thing, you may find a whole, the concentration has got very much increased. Now if you increase time, tech DNA polymerase has a limitation that its strength lacks after a certain period of time. It will be not able to amplify genes anymore. So this is a vital point that has to be kept in mind, that the strength of tagged DNA polymerase is having a limitation. It cannot do proofreading, exonuclease activity. So fidelity rate is very low, stability is also less. It is unable to have the amplification of larger genes. This is also a point. And the strength also reduces. Like after a certain period of time, it might be happen that you are doing everything. You can increase time, you can increase tag DNA polymerase, you can increase buffer, you can do all the things, yet you will find that no more it is able to amplify. Limitation, besides a point that I have missed out to be discussed, that it loses its strength also. Like the strength in a thermocycler, when we are putting our target DNA, primers, nucleotides, buffer solution, mineral oil, tagged DNA polymerase, after running multiple copies, we are able to get the target DNA in pure form. Because earlier what we found is that the target DNA comes in the middle and the primers come at the two ends. Means after running many cycles, 30 to 40 cycles we run, then we are able to get our target DNA in pure form. Now the question is, thermocycler, there are some problems, we cannot check in between. So here comes the requirement that as we load everything, we run the PCR, and after 3 hours or 4 hours we find that we are able to get the DNA which is not in a very pure form. And there are some problems also in primer annealing. These are some of the factors. So in that case, we have to monitor the PCR. For that, we need to do RT-PCR, which will be another topic for discussion. Real-time polymerase chain reaction, where we will be checking on or the monitoring on the process of PCR that is taking place in thermocycler. Another is that primer designing self-complementarity should be avoided, so that the sequences should not be such that it is matching with their own cells and the primers are binding with primers only and they become dimers, hairpin like loop. That should not happen. So advantages of PCR. Advantage, fast. Amplification of gene can be done in a much faster process. In gene cloning, it's time consuming, expensive, and the process is very long. But in case of PCR, there is a benefit that it is very rapid, robust. You can have multiple number of copies within less period of time and less expensive. In case of PCR, gene cloning is also a process where we can get copies. But in that case, what is happening in gene cloning, the process is very long, expensive, more time which has to be given. So to avoid that, we go for a PCR, which is yet a simpler process, rapid also, robust also. You can carry out as I have mentioned in the molecular biology labs, it is carried out in much easier way. But the problem is that in the thermocycler, when you load everything and run the PCR, and then after the whole process, you may find that the whole process has been done, yet we are not able to get the target DNA in a purified form. This is a very big problem, and to erase this problem, we have another monitoring process of PCR, that is RT-PCR, where we can have a monitoring of the PCR. Once you load everything, you cannot check in between, which can be done in a better way in real-time PCR, but in this case the probes that are used are very expensive. So these are some of the points. Besides, the PCR technique is basically nothing, only 3 steps: denaturation, primer annealing, and extension. But requirements that the sequence must be known, primer designing, tagged DNA polymerase, what are the properties of tagged DNA polymerase, do we have a better choice or not? Yes, we have a better choice. We have PFU DNA polymerase, which is really having the proof reading activity done at the 3' hydroxyl end, exonuclease activity. As the strand grows before extension, it can be done. So we have a better choice. And PCR components I have discussed so far. So I hope that you have got the basic idea of PCR is very clear to you. And moving on, another topic is going to come in my next video. Before that, I will say once more that you please keep on encouraging me, supporting me. Please write to me also what are the topics you want me to discuss more. And with this, I'm just going to say a goodbye to all of you. Thank you.